A prominent figure in the Yellow Vest movement is facing a suspended sentence and a €500 fine for failing to declare the organising of the protests. However, Eric Drouet denies that he is an organiser of the rallies. The Yellow Vests have been demonstrating since November against rising fuel prices and the cost of living. But since last week, the movement has stopped announcing the location of protests to stop what it calls excessive police violence against demonstrators.
It was collectively decided that we will no longer announce our Paris protests. We will never be complicit in government violence.
Well, we can cross live now to political commentator Jean Bricmont. Jean, welcome to the programme. Now, is the case politically motivated, as Drouet's lawyer says?
Well, obviously it's politically motivated. You see, you must realise that the repression is very intense. I just saw a video of a young woman, 20-year-old student in philosophy, perfectly peaceful, who lost an eye for the rest of her life because of the repression. So, of course, that's not very encouraging to say where you're going to demonstrate. It's quite obvious that the police have been shooting at perfectly peaceful demonstrators with real bullets, rubber bullets or whatever you call them, but they wound, and they have tens of people wounded for life, handicapped, etc. So, of course, people are not tempted to say where they're going to demonstrate. Now, I don't know about the specific case of Drouet. That's for the court and the lawyers to discuss, but the general picture is that what does the government do? First of all, they slander the movement, mostly through accusation of anti-Semitism, because of a few incidents of which there is no proof that the Yellow Vest are responsible for, or that they're responsible as a movement. I mean, they certainly are not, but they are, stirring up hysteria about anti-Semitism in order to discredit the movement. The other thing they are doing is try to ignore them and wait till it stops. And the third thing they are going to do is repression. I mean, they've just gave a year of, year of jail to the boxer who had been boxing policemen. Of course, that's not exactly peaceful demonstration, but of course you have to see in the context of France that that's a relatively heavy sentence. So one can, it's obvious that the government is trying to repress and they are going to try to attack leaders. One of the leaders has already lost an eye. And his Drouet now is taken to court. They are also trying to create then fake movement who are going to present electoral list to the European election, which is a way to divide the opposition to Macron, maybe allow the movement of Macron to win the European elections after all. So everything is used to destroy this movement, as was to be expected, because there's nothing they can do. I mean, they can't satisfy their demand. I mean, satisfying their demand would mean a basic reorientation of the economy, and that's of course not in the card. I mean, even if they wanted to, the European Union would prevent them from doing so.
What do you think the consequences will be if the movement stops announcing its protests?
Well, that's anybody's guess. I mean, they are certainly going to try to repress, but you see, the problem is that the more they repress, the more they make themselves unpopular. So, I don't know. I mean, I always expected that the movement as it is, namely with demonstration every week on Saturday, will eventually, slow down and maybe stop. I mean, you can't have this demonstration forever without the government doing anything, and there is no sign of the government capitulating anyway because they have too much powers behind them. But the movement can organize itself in different ways. You see, they can organize themselves and try to educate the rest of the population and eventually create a movement of opposition that may be deeper than this demonstration or than the list at the European elections.